Tryon Palace is significant in New Bern's history because it's the first permanent capital that the colony of North Carolina had. Before the palace was built, every new governor we had moved the capital to a different town. At this point, with the palace, the governor comes to the capital. It was also the first state capital for the new state of North Carolina after the Revolutionary War. The palace is also significant because it's where the governor's council met. These were 12 men who were chosen by the governor, but appointed by the king, and they could serve for life to help rule the colony, as long as they stayed in the king and the governor's good graces. After Governor Tryon left and Governor Josiah Martin fled, and we became the budding new state of North Carolina, George Washington, when he was on his southern tour in 1791, came and stayed in New Bern for 2 nights. While he was here, they threw a grand ball for him in what was the new Capitol building for the state. He said it was a great brick building hastening to ruin. The original palace's history ends as a public building in 1794 when Richard Dobbs Bate, who was a governor of North Carolina but also a signer of the Constitution, moved the capital from New Bern to Raleigh. The palace only lasted 4 years after that before it burned in a fire. The original palace was built not just to be a home for the governor, but also a home for the government. The governor's family lived on the second floor while the upper house of North Carolina's colonial government met in the council chamber on the first floor. Now, Governor Tryon, who oversaw the palace being built, lived there for 13 months, and then King George III had him go to become the governor of what was seen as a more prestigious colony, New York. When he left, we got our last royal governor, Governor Josiah Martin. He lived there from 1771 till right at the beginning of the Revolution, when he fled down to Wilmington and tried to run the government off of a ship for a while before things proved ineffective and he fled to New York, which was safer for loyalists. The reason Governor Martin fled was, quite frankly, he was fairly scared for his life. New Bern was known to be one of the most patriotic towns in North Carolina, and Governor Martin knew that he had 6 cannons that were facing the river. They were always there to help defend the palace from access from the water. But he was afraid that if a mob came, they could take over the palace, capture those guns, and then use them against loyal British subjects. So he had the 6 guns dismantled. The people of New Bern came in a big crowd, demanded to speak to the governor, wanting to know why he had done that. They thought he was up to something. He settled them down, but he knew basically his time was numbered. He packed up his wife and children and sent them to her family in New York for safety. And he was going to hold down the government for a while in New Bern for a couple of days, and then he was going to flee. After he fled, the people in New Bern found out that he had not only dismantled those cannons, but buried a large amount of gunpowder and ammunition in the cabbage patch of the kitchen garden. He was so scared of the Patriots. Although the original palace only stood for 28 years, it experienced a lot in its time. The history of the palace echoes the history of New Bern, and both the city and the edifice are symbolic of the experiences that the people who lived in this town faced, whether it was hard times or great new hope. And the palace and New Bern will continue to stand for many years to teach those lessons to the people who come after us.